You're watching Czar Films Variety Channel.
All right, hi there. Today we are going to show you how to, or we're going to try anyway. This is we're going to show you how to clone your hard drive to a M.2 SSD drive. What we have here is an Acer Aspire laptop. This is the E5-575-33BM. It has 16 gigs of RAM, and we installed a M.2 drive, 275 gigabyte M.2 drive, SSD drive, into the open slot. So what we're going to try to do now is clone our hard drive that it came with, the HDD, at the 1 terabyte drive, onto the 275 SSD drive, and clone it, and then make the SSD drive the boot drive. And then we'll wipe the terabyte drive that came with the laptop clean and use that for storage. That's the plan. We're going to give it a try. So what we've done is we've gone to a website that will help us clone it. It's Easeus.com. I'm not an affiliate or anything. I've just downloaded the free program for backup, and this is the trial version. It's the Easeus TODO Backup software. That's what it's called. So we're going to go ahead and open it. And try to run the trial and see if we can get this to do okay. Do you want to allow the app to make changes to your device? Yes. So first, before you do this, you want to go ahead and make sure that what's on your hard drive, the terabyte drive, is not bigger than what's on the amount of gigabyte space is not more than what you're trying to clone onto the SSD drive. Right now this computer is new. It doesn't have very much on there. It's just a few, you know, like 30 gigabytes, 80 gigabytes, whatever it is. So we're just going to clone it to the SSD drive, but you need to make sure that you don't have more data than you're trying to put on there. It won't work. So it says, do we want this to make changes to your device? Yes. You also want to defrag your hard drive and back it up. We backed up whatever important files we had on an SD drive. This is a SanDisk Cruiser, 32 gig. We use that just for some of our personal files. We had a few files on there that we wanted to back up. Make sure you do a backup. If you have a backup for your operating system through any other backup system, hard drive or SkyDrive or whatever, do that first before you attempt to do this. There we go. So we're going to click yes. So we're installing it, basically. Okay. So what we're doing is installing this onto the drive that we're operating from, the SSD drive. Oh, you also want to, after you install your SSD drive, you want to go ahead and initialize it so that the drive can see it, if you haven't already done so. Okay, whoop. There we go. My backups, okay. Alright, so it's installing the program. So there are other programs out there. This is a free one that you can get for 30 days, so we figure we'd give it a try. You want your SSD drive to be the boot drive so that you get the benefit of the speed. And this is a very slow, clunky terabyte drive, although it's big, that comes with this Aspire. It's a good idea to, you know, make the SSD drive your boot drive. So that's what we're attempting to do. People have asked me to do this, so I'm going to give it a shot. So here we go. Zoom in a little bit there. Okay, complete trial setup. Okay, finish. Okay, installation. Easeus TODO. All right, here we go. Oh, nope, it says later. Click later. Okay. So, What we're looking to do is clone, so we're going to go up here and choose clone. Click OK. Then we want to make sure, okay, our hard disk right here. So source, this is the terabyte drive that came with it. So that's the source drive. So then you go down to the lower corner and click next. The source obviously is where all the data that, you know, our data from the other drive is coming from. You can see that the second drive is the 256 gigabyte SSD drive. So next. And then target drive, hard disk, disk one, next. And it's saying proceed. The data on the destination disk will be lost. Do you want to continue? There's nothing on that disk, so we're going to go ahead and click OK. So it's going to go ahead and clone the drive. It's doing it right now. We'll see if it works. And cloning. Other people indicated that they could just disconnect the internal terabyte drive and then just boot it up with the SSD drive, and you'd be able to install Windows right from Microsoft, and I think that's possible, and we may try that if this doesn't work. But we had some other things installed, like some virus protection and stuff like that, that we wanted to carry over. That's why we're cloning the drive and trying to start it without having to download Windows again. That's the whole point. You also don't need a key code for Windows if you're cloning just on the same device. They've done away with that. So it says initialized is in clone, please wait, start clone, enable checking partition. Alright, it's going quick now here, about 2 minutes. Clone volume via sector by sector. Alright. It's about 10 minutes it's going to take. It's cloning drive. Alright, this seems to be working, so we want the benefit of the speed of the SSD on boot. We're going to go into the BIOS, and once this clone is confirmed and everything's on the SSD drive, we're going to go into the BIOS on startup and make the SSD drive, the Crucial, the boot drive, and then try to boot it from there. And if it works and we can, everything's functioning, then you want to go ahead and format the terabyte drive, and that'll wipe it clean, and you'll have a very fast supercomputer with the SSD drive for the boot drive. So that's basically what we're trying to do here. Like 20 minutes estimated time still. About halfway through. Okay, looks like we're getting near the end. It says clone completed, clone volume via sector by sector. It took about 26 minutes and we're about 3 minutes left. This is awesome. Start assigning drive letter. Alright, here we are. It says, disk clone completed successfully. It took 26 minutes and 49 seconds. So, let's go ahead and close that. And we're just going to take a quick look here in the settings. system. Storage. So we've got the two drives here. Yep, so it took 79 gigs from there and put 78.1 onto disk E, which is the SSD drive. So it looks like it works. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to shut the computer down. All right. Shut down. Now we're going to start it back up, but we're going to push F2 to get into the BIOS. We got here, the Toshiba was first and the Crucial was second. So we're going to push F6 to move the Crucial up in the thing. Then we're going to go ahead and push the left arrow to the exit, and we're exit saving changes. Hit enter. Save configuration. And exit now. Hit yes. And now, okay, it shut down. And we want to hopefully it will reboot. Alright, so in order to change or check the boot drive on this Acer, we're just going to go ahead and just do a couple things here. So we're going to need to make sure we need to enable the F12 function. So we're going to go ahead and power the system down. We'll restart it. And as the logo appears on the screen, we'll push F2 to get into the BIOS. F2 into BIOS, over to main, go down to F12 boot menu. It's now disabled. We want to select enabled, enter, press F10 to save changes and restart the system. Save configuration and exit now. Yes, enter. Okay. I'm going to go with F12. It should give us a boot menu. Okay. Boot Windows, boot manager. It's got the Crucial, it is booting from the hard drive, so that's how you do it. It's pretty simple. You just got to get into your BIOS or enable your F12 function and make your boot manager hit the Crucial. And that is how you make your boot drive, your SSD drive. So now we can go ahead and wipe the terabyte drive, and we're back in business with the SSD. It is booting. Yeah, it's booting very quick, so we did it. That's how you make your SSD drive, your clone drive, boot up a clone drive, using that Easeus TODO program. And as you can see now, we've gone in and checked our main drive. Now this PC is the one that has 255 gigabytes, and the local drive for storage is now the hard drive. So once you get into the BIOS and switch the booting order, you're all set. So we're going to go ahead and wipe our local disk drive, and now we've got a terabyte of storage, and we're booting off the M2 SSD drive. So that's the other way you can double check to make sure what you're booting off of. So thanks again. Work like a charm. Took about half an hour. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it. Please like, subscribe. I hope that helps you guys. Thank you so much for the suggestion.